tell you a tale that'll bust your heart that only a few people knew to start. It all took place when our concert tour was booked at the SeaTac Hilton. I'll guarantee every word's gospel truth, got witnesses to prove it too, cause we all toured with a fella by the name of Milton. Now Milton was official tour director, electrical piano playing plug connector, and the slave driving his travel conductor that we ever seen in our lives. He'd say, what do you mean you need more rest? The world don't care whether you look your best. Simply show up promptly at 6 a.m. with your instruments and your wives.
Shall we gather at the airport?
He'd always arrive in the nick of time, a good 5 minutes ahead of flight time, and looking like he'd been drug through an eagle's eye. He'd stand there stoned and about to choke on his Egg McMuffin and his giant Coke, and then he'd throw all the tickets on the counter and say,
check the bag and let's fly. Well, what do you mean this is too much weight? We only got 46 pieces of freight, and if it don't go, who's gonna explain it to our fan club in Tacoma?
We'd all get embarrassed and head for the plane while Milton stood there being profane, but somehow he always managed to get on board in a sort of a coma.
When the drinks were served up yonder,
well, we deplaned at the t'other end. All the trouble seemed to commence again, though Milton had ordered 3 station wagons, a pickup truck, and a limo, and though he'd phoned ahead to that number too, cussing and fussing and turning blue, we'd always end up with 2 Datsuns and a Pinto. Now Milton took all of that stuff in stride, laid on the floor and kicked and cried, but we always looked up to him for hope and salvation. But we'd sink to the bottom of Traveler's Hill when he'd check us in a remote motel, and he'd grab the clerk by a shirt and tie and say,
what do you mean, no reservations?
Milton's getting bolder.
He'd shut himself in room 104, let nobody in till he'd swept the floor, adjusted the lampshade, aligned the TV, fixed the faucet, and called the promoter.
Well, what do you mean we're the warm-up show? You're putting me on. We're stars, you know? And this ain't the way we was treated last summer at Six Flags Over Dakota. Now we gotta have 100% top billing, 2/3 in advance. Of course, you silly, I'm sure we prefer a chauffeured limousine and 2 air-conditioned dressing rooms, please. I'm what? Well, so is your wife. She's not. Well, to each his own. Beg pardon, stick it in my what? Well, really, Merle who?
William Morris, keep us working.
Now, Milton was a real good friend of mine, and we'd stuck together on down that line, but there was one or two points over which we'd just have to debate. Like taking your clothes off and hanging from across in front of the Tri-County Fairgrounds is not necessarily an assurance that the crowd ain't gonna start throwing tomatoes. And when you arrive at 4 for a 5 o'clock show and the stage ain't built and there's no electricity, about all you could do is sit on your butt and cut bait. However, you give old Milton 4 strong bodies, a 9-foot grand, a beard, and a cigarette, and you just knew that show was gonna be out of state.
Bringing in the bread.
Now, one night up there in Washington, we didn't get paid for a show we'd done, and poor old Milton couldn't live with that, and his brain just shorted out. Well, he locked himself in the bathroom, and then when he didn't come out for an hour and a half, we figured that something was wrong, but we had to remove all doubt. We stood transfixed in shock and horror when we busted down at their bathroom door, and I hope I never see a sight like that again. No, I don't. There was nothing to do but close our eyes, bow our heads, and vocalize with a silent 5-part a cappella hymn for him.
What a friend we had in Milton.
Now, we're getting ready come next December to put another concert tour together, and I'm sad to say old Milton ain't gonna be with us. No, it ain't going to be exactly the same when they introduce us without his name. So, Milton, wherever you are, we hope you miss us. See, Milton has moved on down the road, over the rainbow, looking for gold. Yeah, he's up there where the stage lights is always on. But we can't forget that curly hair when last we saw him was sitting there, holding his tambourine, sucking his thumb, and sound asleep on the John.